How are you all? I hope you are well being fine at home. See, at home you have to do study also and you have to take care of yourself. Okay? Today we are going to start our geography 4th lesson, structure of ocean floor. That we already learned half parts in our previous class. That is about the marine reef, marine trenches, beds, right? And today we are going to learn about the marine deposition. That is the marine depositions and main sea level. What is that? About this today we are going to study. See the page number 25, marine depositions. The marine beds are the deep parts of world in respective region. Hence, various deposits are found in these parts. The deposits are as follows. We already learned that if there is a sea, there is a downside. We can see the beds, right? Ocean beds. And there is, we can found the deposits. That is, what are the deposits? That is the pebbles, clay, soil, etc. Many times we saw whenever you are going near to the or at the coastal areas, right? Or at the continental shelf, that time we can see there is the sands, pebbles, right? That is called the deposits. The pebbles, clay, soil, etc. brought by rivers, glaciers, etc. from the continent. Whenever we are going deep to the ocean, there are the many pebbles or different colors of pebbles we can see. If you saw the Discovery Channels, from that you can come to know what is the vast ocean is, what is inside the ocean, how the animals, living organism is there, the sand is there, that other things, marine sediments are there, that all the details we can come to know because of the Discovery Channel. And other than you can search in YouTube also. Like obviously we are this nowadays we are learning this from the videos. So you can check the videos, you can come to know about the deep, what is the deep in the ocean. Then the deposition occurs mainly on the continental shelf. These are called marine deposits. See, all this deposition occurs where it is occurs to the continental shelf. We already learned that is this is coast area, right? Here we can see the continental shelf, which is not shallow and it is near to the coastal area. Then second, the lava and ash erupting out of volcanic eruption is also found here. Fine soil particles are deposited on a large scale. Remains of marine plants and animals are mixed in these deposits. This mixture is made up of fine particles and lies in form of fine clay. This is around 30% of the deposit. These are called marine oases. See, that area of lava and ash eruption is also there. Then the fine soil particles are deposited on large scale. See, whenever you are going to the continental shelf, there also you can find the soil particles, then pebbles, and the remains of marine plants and animals are mixed in this deposit, and the mixture is made up of fine particles. Same that we observe that plants and animals, whatever is there, they are also mixed with that deposit and they find the fine clay. This is around 30% of the deposit, and what is the percent of that? It is the 30%. These are called marine oases. That name is called, that is the mixture of plants, animals to this deposits. It is up to the 30%, and this is called the marine oases. To understand the form of the marine life in the ocean and the availability of minerals on the ocean bed, these deposits are very important. Sedimentary rocks are formed due to the depositing of layers over layers of the sediments and the pressure of seawater. See, in this picture there is a given the marine depositions, how the depositions is formed. Yes, as the plants, animals are mixed with the deposit, that is the papers, clay, sand, soil particles and all the things. It is mixed with it to form the layers, and as the marine deposition is formed. Then next is the marine sediments. See the marine sediments, we can see in this picture how it is looking. As the layer of the layer is deposition layer is formed over and over, and it formed into the sediment. Sedimentary rocks are formed due to the depositing of layers over layers of the sediment and pressure of seawater. See, as the sea or ocean is very vast, there is also pressure is also there, and because of this deposition layers and pressure of seawater, the sedimentary are formed. Besides, some human induced material is also found here. This includes several solid waste, radioactive material, waste chemicals, plastics, etc. These wastes prove hazardous to the hydrosphere. These materials are extremely harmful to the marine life and its environment. Through the polluting component are less, the nuisance value is more. See, the manifest human also drop the some wastage like plastics, then cement, solid wastage, water, polluted water from the factory. This all these wastages where we live, that is in the river, that is in the, and that river is mixed with the ocean, with the sea. That means this wastage, whatever the wastage, that also you can find there, like the plastic. See that we know the plastic is not melted, right? It is remain as it is. So it is, we can found there also, but because of this wastage, because of this plastic sewage, what happens? The air is water is getting polluted, and thus it pollutes our environment. Thus it pollutes the water, and because of this pollution, because of this hygienic and poisonous thing, whatever getting in the water, what happens? The living water, living organism begin the diet. It is harmful for the water living organism. Always remember, mean sea level. Elevation or depth of any place is measured from the sea level. The average of the highest high tides and the lowest low tides is considered as sea level. This average is taken to be zero, and altitude or depth are measured and shown in positive or negative values. For example, Mount Everest is 8,848 meters high, and Marine Trenches is -11,034 meters. For survey purpose, in India, the height of sea level at Chennai is considered to be zero, and the elevation of any place in India is measured with reference to this. See what here given, that whenever we have to measure about the highest and deepest, but we have to measure according to the sea level. See, if there is a sea level here, and when we have to measure the highest high tide and lowest low tide, then we have to measure it is from the sea level. That only we can come to know it is the highest, how much it is the highest, and how much it is the low tide. Okay, then also the any depth or any highest, we have to measure from the sea level. Then as there is a given, Mount Everest is 8,848 meters high, and Mariana Trench is -7,000. See, whenever we have to give the about the height, we have to give this, we can give it with the positive number. And we, if we have to measure in the lowest or deepest, then we can give the negative number. And there is a for Mount Everest, what number is given as it is a height? So that is the 8,848 meters. And when we are talking about the deepest, okay, for that we have to give the minus sign, and it is given the Mariana Trench is -11,034 meters. What? See in the example, see in the picture is there. We can see there is a Mount Everest is given, it is meter, and downside there is a Mariana Trench that is given in this picture. From that also we can come to know from the height, for the height plus sign, for the defect it is the minus sign. Page number 27, give a try. From the map of ocean floor, identify the ocean. See, from this map we have to find out the ocean. Can you identify the different submerged landforms shown in the diagram? Can you give this? You can take a map. You have to find out that ocean, submerged. Okay. Always remember, deposition of many materials coming from land keeps occurring in the seas and oceans. This is in the form of natural deposit and sediment. But man disposes unwanted materials in the sea. This poses a hazard to the ocean bed and sea water. Also, it is harmful to marine life. We must keep in mind that biodiversity found in seas and ocean is higher than on the land. See, many times man disposes the unwanted things away and the wastage material to the ocean, to the river. So it is harmful to the marine life. Okay, it is harmful to the living organism which are live in water. And we must keep the mind that biodiversity found in seas and ocean is higher than on the land. That means the biodiversity, that is the number of plants, animals are on the land, it is very in a huge number than the land. See, as we know the water take. In our earth, there is water land, or water, it takes the more land than the land surface, right? So, the living organism, plants and animals are biodiversity is also there by the land. Then use your brain power. See, about the given questions, the materials coming along with the waves that given, which materials are coming? Whenever there is a wave, so whatever materials with the that water, it is also moved with the waves. Okay, then which are? First one is the natural and artificial, that is the man-made. Then in natural, which materials like the plants, conches and cells and aquatic animals. See, if the waves is high, then the small animals was there, that is also come and move with that waves. Then second is the artificial and man-made. That is, in artificial man-made, which material? That is chemicals, metals, plastic and glass. We already know about the that man is live the plastic materials, glass material or any chemical materials to the water, throw it into the water, and that is the chemical materials. It is also coming and move with the waves here and there. See, there are some questions are asking that this question, use your brain power. We are going to study in our next class. Next, do you know? While studying the ocean floor, we must keep in mind the age of the ocean bed. By studying the deposit on the ocean bed, it occurred to the scientists that the deposit at the ocean floor are not older than the 200 million years. See, as the according to the scientists, they study about these deposits and study about the bedrocks, all that thing. And they come to know that deposits are not older than the 200 million years. The maximum age of the rock on the continent is supposed to be 3200 million years. Then, where have the deposits on the seabed which are older than the 200 million years gone? This made the scientists research. See, as when the scientists observe, as they examine study, they come to know that deposits are not more than the 200 million years. Okay, but as suppose this should be the 3200 million old, but if it is not, then in previous time, where is that deposits and where it is gone if it is not older than the 200 million. Say, then what they are doing, they studied about the rocks. then they started the study of the rocks along with the deposits. This made them realize that the rocks are also not older than 200 million years. It was inferred that the ocean floor is very young as compared to the Earth's surface. Now this is unanimously accepted. This research was in use in the study of concept of plate tectonics. See, as the scientists examine the study about the deposits, they come to know it is not older than the 200 million years. Then they restless. How it is possible? As the Earth is very old, and according to that, it should be the 3200 million. But it is not there. Then they study about the rocks. And they come to know that rocks is also not more than, it is not older more than the 200 million years. That means this ocean surface, that ocean floor is younger than the Earth. That means first the Earth formed and after many years that ocean floors are formed, water is formed on the Earth. Now I hope you understood about the structure of ocean floor. That in that we learn about the details of the ocean, what is the ocean, how we have to measure what is the marine deposition and sea level. Then try to find out about these questions, answer and read this lesson carefully.